Hello and welcome. Today we're doing a question from LeetCode. This is called Flood Fill, and I believe this question is from Grind75. We've been doing a lot of playlists with that 75 set. We have Blind 75, LeetCode 75, and now this is also from Grind75. These are pretty good playlists to use, and if you are interview prepping, either of these playlists work. The most important thing is to make sure you are covering a good variety of topics and are fully understanding each topic. So for this question, what are we going to do? You are given an image represented by an m by n grid of integers image, where image ij represents the pixel value of the image. You are also given three integers, sr, sc, and color. Your task is to perform a flood fill on the image, starting from pixel image sr, sc. So these are basically row and column indices. To perform a flood fill, begin with the starting pixel and change its color to that given input color we have. Perform the same process for each pixel that is directly adjacent, pixels that share a side with the original pixel, either horizontally or vertically, and share the same color as the starting pixel. So the pixels need to be either left, right, up, or down to our starting pixel and need to be that same original color. And we keep repeating this process by checking neighboring pixels of the updated pixels, modifying their color if it matches the original color of the starting pixel. This process stops when there are no more adjacent pixels of the original color to update. Return the modified image after performing the flood fill. So example one, this is our input, right? We have our image grid here, and the numbers represent colors. We start off at index 1, 1 over here, and we want to change it to be color 2. So we change this to be color 2, then we check what's up, down, left, and right, directly adjacent to our own cell, and has the same color as our starting cell. We change this to 2, but now we also want to change these two into 2. Then we see what's adjacent to these, and we get the remaining cells, which are all going to be changed to 2. We'll never be able to access this cell, because while it is a 1, it's not directly adjacent to any other pixel, so this will remain a 1. And this is example 2. We have an array image of all zeros. So this is what it looks like. And we start off at index 0, 0 right over here. And we want to change it into color 0. Now we're already a 0, which means there's nothing we need to change. And we'll just return the image as is. So this is our output. And we have some constraints over here. Okay, so how are we going to be solving this? There are actually two ways to solve this. Looking back at example 1, if we start over at this index 1, 1, one way to solve this would be to do a DFS. So we would go down a path of all the ones we see and change them into being 2s. So at this cell, say we check left, down, right, up. The first thing we'll do is check left. Now this is a value of 1, so we do want to make that change into a 2. Now there's nothing to the left of this index. There is something down below. So now we're gonna go here. Now here we change this to a 2, there's nothing to the left, down, right is a 0, we can't make any changes, and the top has now been changed to a 2, so we can't make any change there. So we're done branching out from this cell, and we return back to our color. At this point, we just came from down below, we can check to the right, this had been changed to 2, so now we check up. At this point, there is nothing to the top, left, down has already been changed, so we just go right, and we'll just go down that entire path, changing all the ones that we can get to into 2s. And LeetCode actually already has a solution for it, the DFS approach. This is a recursive approach if you do want to look at it. Now, since the DFS approach is already there, I'm going to be doing it the other way through a BFS. Now, this is a breadth-first search, meaning we're not going down a path changing all the colors into the new color we want to update it to. Instead, we're going to be going out in layers. So if I'm at this index over here, I'm going to see what's left, top, bottom, and right of me. And any cells that have the same number as me, I'm just going to change their value. So I have these two over here, which will then become 2. So all these three will be 2s. Then at this point, since these two indices were my next layer, I'm now going to use those to continue branching out. So from these two indices, what cells can we reach and branch out to? So the next layer will be this cell over here, this one here, and this one here. These are directly adjacent and also the same number as our original cells. So these will also become 2s. Now for these three cells, there's nothing else to go out from. This is our last layer. We can't make another layer. So we're done and we'll just return our modified image. And that's all we really need to do. It's pretty straightforward for ABFS. So now that we know what we need to do, how are we going to code this up? To code this up, say we are looking at example one again. This is our image array and our input is 1, 1, and 2. What we want to do is start off at our current cell over here and figure out what that color is. So current color is going to be what we have an image of SR and SC. Now this color is the same as that new color we want to update it to. We'll just return our image. We saw in example two, there's no modifications needed. So this is going to be one of our base cases. If current color equals the color that we had as our input, we would just return our image. Now at this point, if we don't return, that means we do want to make changes to our color and we want to be going out in layers. So our current layer is going to hold that index that we are starting with. So it's going to be SRSC. This is 1, 1 that we are starting with. So I have our variables defined below. We have current color being 1 and current layer being 1, 1. Now what we want to do is we want to branch out from current. So while current, while there are still elements we can branch out from, we just want to loop through all the indices available and actually branch out. So for row column in current, so right now our row is going to start off with 1 and column is going to also start off with 1. We want to check in the four directions, right? What is adjacent to us? So check is going to be a list of indices, R plus 1, C. This is going to be checking the index right below us. So if we start off at 1, 1, R plus 1, C will put us at 2, 1. Now we also want to check what's above us, so R minus 1 and C. To the right of us, so R, C plus 1. And to the left of us, R, C minus 1. These are all the indices we want to be checking, so all we need to do is just loop through. So 4, let's call this check R and check column. So for these indices, what do we want to do? We want to make sure that index is actually in bounds. We are checking R plus 1, minus 1, C plus 1, C minus 1. It could be out of bounds. So first thing is to make sure it is in bounds. So what is actually the length of our input image? Let's say M and N are going to represent the length. So M is going to be length of image and N is going to represent the length of image of 0 because we are given an M by N grid. So for CR and CC, the indices we want to be checking, we want to make sure they're in bounds. So if CR is greater than or equal to 0 and CC is greater than or equal to 0 and CR is less than M and CC is less than N and image at CR CC equals that current color we had. It also needs to be that same color, right? If it's not the same color, we can't check that. So this needs to equal current color. If this is true, then we can update that cell. So image at CRCC is going to be that color we want to change it into. And we also want to add this cell to our new layer we want to expand out from later on. So let's actually make a new layer, initialize that to be empty, and append this on. So new layer dot append CRCC. Now, once we are through this for loop, we would have checked in all four directions, and we would have done that for all the cells we have in our current layer. Once that's done, we want to start off from our new layer. So our current layer is just going to equal new layer. So current is going to equal new layer. And once we exit our while loop, there are no more indices for us to branch out from. All we have to do is just return our modified image. So again, what did we do? We started off. Oh, this should have been no N here. So we started off getting our dimensions. We got the color of our starting index. If it equals the color we want to change it to, we would just return the image as is. Then we want to start branching off in layers from that index we are on. And actually, we should have also changed the color of that beginning index. So image of SRSC should equal color. Once that's done, we are going out in layers. We're going to initialize our new layer. Loop through all the indices we have right now, make a check in four directions, loop through these indices. So for CR, CC in check, we just make sure they are in bounds and the same value that we have, change it to be updated to that new color, append that index to a layer, and then set current to be new layer. So let's go ahead and submit this. And it is accepted. Now talking about space and time complexity, four times, since we are hitting potentially every single cell in our grid, it is going to be O of N if we have N cells in total. You could also say this is O of m times n if you are going by the dimensions. And for space, it would be the same. Now, before leaving, let's just go through our example super quickly, just so we know exactly how our code is going to run line by line. So quickly, just going through our example, we had our current color being 1, we had our current being 1, 1, and we had a checklist that we needed to loop through. And of course, we added that change to our index, so this then becomes 2. So we were over here, we're looping through CR, CC, and check, and we want to check to make sure they're in bounds and they equal our current color we had. So the first check we're making is this cell over here, 2, 1. It is in bounds, but it doesn't equal that original color we had of 1. So we don't do anything, we don't go in this if, and we go back in this for loop. Now we're at 0, 1, so over here we are in bounds, and it does equal that color we had originally. So what we're gonna do is change this color. So it's going to change to 2, and we also add these indices to our new layer. Now going back in this for loop, we're checking 1, 2. This is in bounds, but it doesn't equal the current color, so we go back again. Checking 1, 0, this is in bounds, does equal current color, so we're going to change this to be 2, and we're just adding that to our new layer. So our new layer now holds these two indices over here. All we need to do is change our current layer to be our new layer. So current is now going to equal this over here. So we go back in this while loop, we initialize new layer to be empty again, and we loop through all the indices in current. So R is 0, C is 1 for the first one, and we make a new checklist. Now looping through all the indices in check, we start off with 1, 1. Remember, we are at this index over here, so we're going to start at the bottom now. It's going to go back to our original starting index. We make a check, it is in bounds, but since we already made this update, we don't need to do it again, right? This color now equals 2, it's not that original color we had. We don't do anything here and go back in the for loop, checking the next pair of indices. Now, negative 1, 1 is going to be out of bounds. CR here is not greater than equal to 0, so we go down to the next one. 0, 2 is in bounds, it is 1, so we make that update and add it to new layer. And moving down for the last one, we are at 0, 0. Again, we can make that update, it is in bounds, and we'll just add 0, 0 to our list. So this is how we layered out from 0, 1. Now, we also want to layer out from 1, 0. So we go back in this for loop over here, make a new checklist. So now starting at 1, 0 over here, doing the same thing, right? We're branching out. So the first thing we're going to check is 2, 0. What's right below this index over here? It is in bounds and it does equal 1. So we make a change. We change this to be 2. And we're just going to append 2, 0 to our new layer. Now going to the next indices, we check what's above us. 0, 0 has already been changed. It doesn't equal that current color we had. So we can move on. We go to 1, 1, same deal here. And then we go to 1, negative 1, but there is nothing here. It's going to be out of bounds. So we don't go in this if. We change current to be this new layer. And we go back in the while loop for one last time. New layer is going to be empty. So starting off with this index over here, we know there's nothing else to branch out from. And we'll see that, right? 1, 2 is a 0. We can't do anything here. Negative 1, 2, that's out of bounds. 0, 3, also out of bounds. And 0, 1 has already been changed. So we can't do anything with this index. What about this one? Now at 0, 0, we're going to see the same thing happening, right? 1, 0 is already a 2. Negative 1, 0 is out of bounds. 0, 1 is a 2. Negative 1, 0 is out of bounds. Now for that very last index, we have 2, 0. We're checking below us. 3, 0 is out of bounds. Above us, 1, 0 is already changed. To the right, 2, 1 is a 0. Nothing we can do. And to the left, again, it is out of bounds. So we didn't add anything to new layer. We are out of this for loop. There are no more elements for us to iterate through. We set current to be new layer, which is empty. So now we can go back in our while loop. Current is now empty. All we need to do is return the image, which has been modified. So we just went ahead and solved flood fill. If you have any questions, let me know down below in the comments. If this video was helpful, like, comment, share, and subscribe. It really supports the channel. And as always, I will see you in the next one.